In Lesson 4.5, students are introduced to the process of ionic bonding. We use the classic example of sodium chloride. Students see a sodium atom and a chlorine atom. The sodium atom has 11 protons and 11 electrons. The chlorine atom has 17 protons and 17 electrons. And they're arranged according to energy levels 2, 8, and 1. And for chlorine, 2, 8, and 7. So what they'll see when we run the animation here is that the chlorine has a stronger pull on sodium's electrons than sodium has for chlorine's electrons, so this electron is going to move over to the chlorine. Since the chlorine will have an extra electron, it becomes negatively charged ion, and since the sodium lost an electron, it'll become a positively charged ion, and then they'll come together. Let's see. So that shows that chlorine has a stronger pull on electrons. Chlorine became a negative ion, sodium became a positive ion, and they came together and formed an ionic bond. Then we also give a series of pictures so that you can take students step by step through what they saw in the video. That the chlorine had a stronger pull for electrons, the electron transferred to the chlorine, it made chlorine a negative ion and sodium a positive ion, and that they came together to form an ionic bond. So we also show a crystal, a sodium chloride crystal, with the chlorines, the chloride ion in this case you would say, has a negative charge and the sodium ion has a positive charge, and the way they arrange themselves is sort of alternating crystal pattern. And then there's a kind of a neat video here as if you were way, way, way down at the atomic level looking at this crystal from different vantage point and what you would see. Now, here's a video showing what happens if you mix sodium metal in chlorine gas. Let's watch and listen.
A small piece of sodium metal is placed in a flask containing yellow chlorine gas. The flask also contains sand to prevent the heat which will be generated by the reaction from cracking the glass. Initially, no reaction is observed between the sodium and the chlorine. The reaction will be initiated by adding a drop of water to the sodium.
Now this is a very exothermic reaction, as you could see, and it created on the inside surface of the glass sodium chloride. So you can show students a scanning electron micrograph of salt crystals and show that the crystal made up of trillions of ions keeps that same cubic pattern. We do have a way for students to make one of these themselves using styrofoam balls as the positive and negative ions, positive sodium and negative chlorine. Also, it can be helpful for students to see an ionic bond where it's not just sodium and chlorine. In this case, it's calcium and chlorine. So in this case, there's a calcium ion, which is 20 protons and 20 electrons, and chlorine, like we've seen before, 17 protons, 17 electrons. In this case, the chlorine will have a stronger attraction for calcium's electrons than calcium has for chlorine's, so the electrons are going to move toward chlorine, and calcium is going to lose two electrons, so it becomes a plus two ion, and chlorine becomes minus one, so since there's two positive charges here, this minus one and this minus one bond to the calcium and create calcium chloride, which is CaCl2. Let's see. There's a stronger attraction here, so it goes that way, becomes two positive charges because it lost two electrons. These each gained an electron, so they became minus, and it ends up they both are attracted to this positive two charges. And then, like before, you can take students through step by step so they, you're sure they understand what happened. If you're in an NGSS state, there's a performance expectation, MSPS 1.1, which says develop models to describe the atomic composition of simple molecules and extended structures. In lesson 4.5, students develop a model of ionic bonding to describe how ionic bonding allows the extended structure of sodium chloride crystal to form. If you look at the foundation boxes, students develop a model to describe phenomena. In this case, they're using a model to describe ionic bonding and how crystals are formed. For disciplinary core ideas, substances are made from different types of atoms. In this case, different types of atoms we're looking at are sodium and chlorine. The substance is sodium chloride. And for scale, proportion, and quantity, the idea is that we're looking at these different scales. We see salt on a macroscopic scale. We look at it with a scanning electron microscope. You see that it has a crystal structure that's like a cube. And you can look all the way down to the ions that make it up in ionic bonding to relate the subatomic model or scale to the macroscopic scale. Thanks for watching, and good luck with the lesson.